plenty for Portugal still to play for. For the USA, they need some momentum. They need a win, that's for sure, here in Russia. USA in the blue, playing from right to left, opting to receive serve, which means they want to attack first to put a point on the board. It'll be the playmaker for Portugal, the setter, Miguel Tavares of the Rennes Volleyball Club in France. The 26-year-old has a really good jump serve, so we'll be looking to put this US pass under pressure. Final game then here in Russia for Portugal and the USA. Best of five sets. Set one, Tavares to serve for Portugal. Here we go. Fantastic. Well, they ran C-quicks against Russia all day yesterday, which is the middle player jumping on the reverse of the setter. But they open this game. Portugal had done their video homework with Stahl, the middle blocker, hitting in front of the setter. So nice bit of deception first up. And now Stahl with this rocket jump serve of his, but he goes off pace to Ferreira. Portugal forced to play finesse. And a good hard swing from De Falco through the wing, puts it off the block and out of play. Just as valuable a way of killing the ball as thumping it down onto the floor. Great pickup from Benjamin Patch. Good swing from the former Long Beach State wing spiker. This hit from Mitchell Stahl, plays his volleyball in the top division in France for Tours VB. Back to the line then for Portugal's captain, Alex Ferreira. Tight start from both teams at the service line. Micah Christensen, the setter for Team USA. He's in Italy for Modena. Really classy player, Christensen. Just didn't get a particularly good line of serve reception into him yesterday to really run the attacks he wanted to run. Good block out hit from Hugo Silva's men. Phelps back at the line, the middle blocker alongside Tvedikanin. Good shot. Tvedikanin is a fantastic attacker, the number four. Not the tallest middle blocker out there on court, but he's almost 100% on his attacks, especially on that reverse. C-quick used by Portugal. Plenty of space for Tvedikanin. And the value of having a tall setter for the USA. 1.98 meters tall. Around about the 6'5 mark. Micah Christensen able to contain the ball off that pass, and a beautiful feed for a super spike from the veteran David Smith. Good coverage from D'Agostino. So he and Shoji switching up at libero. And another C quick. Tvedikanin this time forced to just tip it over. Plenty of space there. D'Agostino just recovered his position in the backcourt. Then had to go again. Good awareness from the Portuguese attackers. 4-all in this race to 25. First four sets to 25 points if we go to 2-all. And then the fifth, the tiebreaker, to 15. Well, I know every match has the possibility of going to that, but this one, distinct opportunity because USA not playing their best volleyball here in Russia and low on confidence. Christensen not happy with his sets early doors, just having a chat to the attackers there. Now the big serving, Marco Ferreira. Good serve, lovely pass Nice block coverage from the Portuguese team. And it's good enough for the point. And it all started with a mix-up on that initial pipe attack set from Micah Christensen. Not quite on the money. It's going away from his body rather than off his shoulder. And that caused the USA all sorts of problems. Portugal used just about every single one of their players yesterday. Out on court, didn't do any good against Russia in a 3-0 loss. It's Italy, my apologies. Christensen on the reverse to Patch. Under pressure, tough to set that ball. And Marco from the back line pummels it away. He's had a bit of a problem this week with stepping on the 3-metre line, which is out of bounds for the backcourt player. That was some height from Giovinazzi, but he's got it right there off of Margatutia's finger for the kill. Very handy lead for Portugal early in this match, and the pressure will continue with Marco's jump serve. Only just hit the net there. If you serve and it actually goes underneath rather than over the net without touching it, it's a cue embarrassment. Bit of a miss hit from Marco. Back to Smith, middle blocker with a decent serve. Oh, wow! What a play. Tavares fixing himself in the air, the setter for Portugal, and firing it at Giovinazzi. Three attacks, three kills for the 20-year-old middleman for Portugal, and that is a really good lead. Portugal up on the USA at the first technical timeout, 8-5.
Back one, right? So that one in trans you'll have to be on, right? And they did it again, and we can release a little bit when we had a good block. Gee, you were all over it that second time. That was a good play, okay? Now, so try and stay a step ahead of it, huh? So what are they going to do next? Talk about it. Yeah.
It's Baror just encouraging his players to discuss. And you do have to. You have to communicate between points. You can't just let everything happen as a lottery. You've got to try and impose some kind of rhythm on the game and some understanding. But even more important than that, when you're communicating, it allows you to learn as the game goes on. And that's what these players are doing, particularly the middle blockers, learning patterns of attacks to make those very fast decisions, reaction and movement time, to make those happen as quickly and as automatically as possible. Simosh with the float serve. Margatutia with the pass. Patch, first hit in anger, is blocked. Good touch from Marco. His brother rolls it off the block for a replay. And Giovinazzi makes it 4 from 4 for the number four. The one proviso I would say here at the moment is that the USA do have players to go to. So if changes need to happen, they will be made by John Spador, who would dearly love at the moment for Michael Christensen to play himself through. The issue they have, though, is if Captain Taylor Sander is injured, if the shoulder is a problem at the moment, then he can't come in. And they don't have a lot of other options through that wide position. Marco flails at that one. It's missed the block, it's missed the defender, it's missed the court. Point USA. And again, carbon copy from Marco. He's getting too far ahead of the ball. So easy, isn't it, this game from the commentary booth? It really is. But down there on the floor, it's a very different situation. Tough block to beat. Marco with two errors in a row leads to a Hugo Silva timeout for Portugal. Thank you. the coach will be disappointed with that because it was a really good start for the Portuguese team to this match. And the last thing they need to do is give any encouragement to the US team. Richard Stoll waits to block. Benjamin Pash with the serve. Oh, decent swing from Alex, but it's pinged him on the way back past the block. So he's hit it into the block of Christensen. Fantastic block, and it's caught him right on the shoulder as that was going out of play. A bit unlucky for the Portuguese captain, but good block by Christensen. Over on two, easily read, but Mitchell Stoll, net touch, gives the point away. Chivedekanin, what a start to the game for him. 4 points already, back to the service line. Just on the edge of the envelope here. Christensen not quite hitting his targets. Mitchell Stoll having to apply the tip. Well, he was really looking to hit that. Positivity from the players, even after a mistake, that's a feature of volleyball. Teams try and get together even if they've just lost a point in the middle of the court. Good swing from Patch, lovely stuff. Had a French coach make a very good point about that to his team a few years ago. Super spike from Patch. Huge leap again from the American with his favoured line shot to beat Gilles. And a big hit, 109.2 kilometres per hour. And the coach's point was that you've got to get together to celebrate your points, but you've got to get together as well if you lose one. It'll just be one dimension in that aspect. Portugal with a messy play. Just not in control of the ball. That tip happened. Real pressure on Tavares and the one-handed set way too wide for Marco. It is a reflection of the week so far for both these teams. Stuttering performances. Sputtering along to 12 all. Nobody really finding a run of any kind of form at the moment in this game. Great shot of the jump serve from Alex Ferreira. Nice response from TJ DeFalco. Just signed for Tono Calippo. Libra volley in the top division of the Italian league. Sends Christensen back to the service line, who may well be an opponent of TJ DeFalco next year in Italy. Has to play defensively on that one. Patch can't get it down. Portugal go again. Marco into the block and out. And some frustrations down there for Team USA. They cannot get going at the moment in this match. Off of the outstretched arm of DeFalco and out of court. Phelps with the serve, long. There you go, there's the communication. And where David Smith is concerned, has the deaf aids in, but very difficult for him to hear in this environment, so lip reads a lot when he's talking to his fellow players. Touch. Marco Tutia plays it off the block for a reuse. USA go again. D'Agostino to Patch. Patch can't put it away again. Real problems for the opposite at the moment. Mega rally developing nicely here. Marco. Portugal get another go. Pushed through the block by Simoes. Little change up from the Portuguese attacker. And a clever play to force it home. And a mega rally, always characterised by the defenders in the backcourt working hard and keeping the ball in play, but a fair bit of frontcourt defence as well going on. Attack after attack, finally Portugal with the put away. Clever play from Simoes. The players puffing and blowing down there. That was a long rally. 14 all. Marco again. Keeps the ball in. Good serve. Well contained by the USA. In particular, Christiansen having to leap right to the top of his reach. But what a wonderful arrival from the middle player, David Smith, to be on hand for that ball to be fed to him. Dear me. David getting that one all wrong. Assistant coach for the USA, Robert Nielsen, looking as concerned as his head coach, John Spiroir. Well, another service error from Portugal means USA lead at the second technical timeout, but the business end of this first set is going to be fascinating. This one is close. We heard the Russian captain interviewed on day one after their 3-0 victory over Portugal, when Portugal took them close in set two. And Igor Kobzias had said, you know, we haven't played Portugal a lot. They play a little bit like Brazil. They were quite difficult to read. And that was a problem for them. Italy have played Portugal a lot and beat them a lot. So yesterday, Italy were just too good for the Portuguese team. But we're back to a similar situation now that Russia had. USA have not played this Portuguese team a lot, and they're struggling to find a rhythm here. Well, that was definitely plan A. Getting the ball to Patch, nice and high, after a good transition play. Nuaga Dutia volleys it in, and Christiansen finds his main man on the opposite. Super spike from Alex Ferreira. That was turbocharged from Portugal. Tavares with a really fast set to the wing. Chivedekanin at the service line. After a good start, the number four has gone a little bit quiet. Good hit, nice pick up from Simoes. Swing, good affirmative attack there from DeFalco. They run that pipe really nicely, but it's a pipe with a dimension to it. Just watch DeFalco pop up from behind the jump of stall. That's really tough for the middle blockers. It's a timing issue that USA create down the middle of the court. Covered by Christiansen. Patch has to roll it off pace. Easy dig for DeFalco. And then Marco, as he missed another one. So, out. Point USA. That's the decision. But as far as the Portuguese captain, Alex, is concerned, this ball hit by his brother. Touched probably the block is the question. Yeah, there we go. So, challenge for Portugal. Did this touch the block or not? If it did, point Portugal. If it didn't, point USA, as already stated on the scoreboard. First big challenge of the game, and I always feel in the back end of a set, they are so important. This could be the key here. 3 points down. Or not. No, it looks like that's just gone on underneath the finger of DeFalco. So no touch. It's worth a look. Alex, the Portuguese captain, was certainly convinced it had touched, but it hadn't. And that's a three-point cushion for Team USA now in set one. This is where they want to be playing from. Muagatutia to serve. Well passed by Simoes. No. Alex once again just taking off more of that angle than was available. He does this quite a lot, Alex, and he does it under pressure as well. These are the big points for Portugal, and you need your captain to put this away, and he hasn't even got it over the net. It was a good block, but he's tried a bit too hard there, and it's not worked. Hugo Silva has called the timeout. Picture Valdir Sequeira, 37 years of age now, the senior player in this team by a long, long way, and part of that fantastic Portuguese squad that was winning big, big matches about a decade ago now in Europe and on the World League. Portugal hasn't quite managed to carry that legacy on, so they've had a dip in form, they've had a bit of time away from the world stage, but a return to the VNL puts them back in the mix. Power tip from Ferreira. And it's been given against the Portuguese captain. There's a net touch by the looks of it. It's either that or he stepped over the centre line. Those are the two issues. So Portugal are going to challenge this because they can. And Alex feels that this was wrongly given against him. So net fault is the decision. Portugal think that he didn't touch the net, then it's their point. Portugal, having lost their first challenge, only have one left. You've got two per set. If you win it, you keep it. If you lose it, you lose it. And there we go. Ball was still alive as Ferreira landed and went into the net. So fault, USA point. Referees got it absolutely right. Alessandra in the number three shirt, still going through a lot of shoulder strengthening exercises. I think there's a little bit of rehab going on there for the captain. And talking of captains, the Portuguese captain has lost his place on court, and on comes Keke, who just looked all at sea against Italy yesterday. Very good, very experienced player. But the 33-year-old is going to have his work cut out here against the USA. Excellent from Marco against the three blockers. Just seen his brother substituted off court, but starting to come to the party here. And once again, Tavares, the playmaker, going to his opposite spiker. And he goes off of the correct blocker. Christiansen not quite as high as the other two. A monumental hit from Tavares. Where did that come from? Miles out. Now, USA can get it over the line with Mitchell Stahl's serve from here. Nice pass from Keke. And well put away. So they've seen the Stahl serve off, Portugal. But still chasing in this first set. Lovely picture over the top of the service reception unit there. And you can see how the players angle themselves towards the server. John Spiroir calls it orientating yourself towards the server. Well, orientate yourself towards that. David Smith with a super spike across his body. And the veteran middle blocker with a big kill. This was a nice hit. Lovely set from Christensen as well. Let's not forget, there's a couple of components have to happen before you get a super spike like that. But well buried by Smith. Good work. Chamois is a clever player. 32-year-old, number 9 for Portugal. Takes his tally to 4, I think, in this game. So Phelps off, and on comes Valdir Sequeira. He's not a middle blocker, Sequeira, he's an opposite player, and one of the best opposites that has graced the game for Portugal over the years. But he's on for his service capability, so he's going to go flat-out power here. Or a little deception and an off-pace. No, it's power, and it's into the net. And for the first time that he's been brought on in that substitution, he's missed. He's actually usually very, very reliable at the service line, but he's just handed a total of 5 set points to the USA. And it'll be TJ DeFalco trying to put it away for the Americans. They've been strong in the back third of this first set. Well, worth going for. That was a serve to nothing, really. If it was in, great, it's all over. Now USA have 4 opportunities to attack to win this first set. Mind you, it's Marco serving for Portugal. Anything can happen when he's at the line, including serving into the net. So 2 serve errors from Portugal, giving the game away, as it were. 25-20. USA looks shaky up to the second technical timeout. But from there on, they looked in control. And the Americans take their first step to what the pundits say will be a 3-0 victory against Portugal today. And Portugal once again have to improve their game management in the last third of the set. That's where it all happens. That's where it gets tough. And unfortunately for them, their captain, Alex Ferreira, not able to deliver. And in the end, taken off the call. Russian fans getting ready for Russia v Italy here in the UEFA Arena. Had a sellout crowd yesterday. We'll have plenty in today. But for the moment, it's USA leading Portugal by 1 set to love. Being given a run for their money in set one, but getting it across the line in the end pretty comfortably, 25 points to 20. Too many errors from Portugal. Look at that. Best part of the set given away in Portuguese errors. Both teams will be upset. So, okay, you want to be in that green zone. That means that all the attackers are available. The setter can do what they want with the ball in offense. So 61% of the time, USA are able to do that. Christensen then getting into the game. It wasn't a great start from him, and saw him apologise to his players on a couple of occasions, the US setter, for not finding them. Day 3 here in Russia. And the quality of the strength and conditioning training that these players and these teams go through. Tested. Always is towards the end of a tournament, or towards the end of one of these round robin 3-day meets. Smelly one from Tavares. That's cheeky. USA defenders will not like that, and DeFalco read it, but a field goal straight through his arms. Oh yes, super spike from Mitchell Stahl. And what both he and David Smith do so well is arrive and drift. So they jump, show the blocker that they're jumping, and then just drift away from that point in the air. And that's where the set arrived from Christensen. That's what allowed this man, Mitchell Stahl, to put a bit of a dent in the Portuguese court. Good serve onto the Portuguese captain, who's back on court. And his brother Marco with a miss. Well, Portugal thought that was in. I think from that end on camera, most of you watching would have felt that, yeah, OK, it was close, but it was long. I'm not sure after losing a couple of challenges in the last set that Hugo Silva was too keen to have a go at this one. And it's not in, so that's not the question. The question is, did it touch the fingers of the US block on the way to going out? Really, challenge-wise, you can't be much further away from the fingers than that. That's a pretty poor call from Portugal, and they will know that. They've burned a challenge really early in set two. Let's hope they don't need that later in the set. Jump float serve passed by Simon. Marco this time touches the block. No challenge required. He falls over a lot, Samosh, when he passes, but it's a really stable pass, generally speaking. Good block, a good block height, but a really good spike height to go over the top from Marco. Big hit, really big hit from the Portuguese captain. Well contained by the US passing unit. That's a nice play from the Americans. Service reception. Since the 80s, since Doug Beal came in and brought that group of students together to win gold in Los Angeles. Service reception from compact, all-round ball control players in the wing spiker position has been the key for Team USA on the world stage. It's a wonderful story, and if you ever get to the chance to read Doug Beal's book, Gold, you should do. It's a great read. The wonderful stories in the history of this sport. Lovely shot, lovely pickup. Marco, no, monster block. There haven't been many in this game. But Patch from his unfamiliar side getting in on it alongside Smith. How well organised was that block? Nowhere to go for the opposite spiker, Marco. Good pass. Easy pickup for Patch. This will go wide again to Marco Tutia. And he gets it off the block and out eventually, despite a really good slide from Tavares, and you're just seeing a few of the players getting up a little slowly from some of these dives. The fatigue, I think, at the end of a tough 3 days starting to tell. And watch as Tavares lands here, right on the breastbone, and the head rocking forward. That knocks the wind out of you. There goes the view that have done a dive on a volleyball court like that will understand exactly what I'm saying. Still no real rhythm for Team USA. And by that, I mean you don't feel like you're flowing through a game. You feel like every single action, every single skill is an individual component under pressure that has to be performed. They're performing it pretty well. Very good attack from USA. Christensen feeding Patch on the reverse. who's just starting to come into the game now. The Berlin recycling volley player in the top division in Germany. It's a nice hit. Two serve errors in a row. Off a jump float serve from David Smith. That's not great from the experienced middleman. General rule is if your teammate put their serve out before you, you shouldn't miss yours, but different rules apply on the VNL. If you don't serve tough, it comes back with interest. Good set to Patch. Patch has missed it. In his defence, the number 13 for the USA, that's a horrible ball to have to hit. Coming over your shoulder and across the front of your body to swing on it with your right hand takes a lot of timing. More than Patch had on that occasion. 6-6, Portugal back in this set. And he's missed that one out on the sideline, say the officials. Challenge USA. Benjamin Patch looked pretty confident that was on the line, but his teammates have talked him out of it, so no challenge. Portugal take the lead. Horrible pass from DeFalco. And a decent kill this time. Patch going up against the three blockers and the deflection, rather than helping Portugal, actually takes it wide of Marco. 7-7, and just like the opening set, somebody's going to lead 8-7 going into the first technical timeout. It will be USA. Well, after that blazing start that Chevedikinen made to score 4 points before the halfway mark, the number four for Portugal now hasn't done anything since then. He's still stranded on four. Misses that one. USA 8-7 in the first technical timeout. Phenomenon I forgot to mention is that day three can sometimes be shouty coach day on the VNL. And Hugo Silva is not a happy man. It's tough. It's tough for the coaches, it's tough for the players, it's tough for the fans. You've got your team where you want them to be, in the top division of world volleyball, playing the best in the world. But game in, game out, you're seeing them play all the way through to 16-all, 17-all, 18-all, and then the wheels come off and the set is lost. That Hugo Silva wants his team to concentrate. That's what his concern was there. Doesn't feel their minds are on the game right now. And maybe not. Certainly not enough to keep Tavares on the court. He's lost his place, the setter. So in comes Violas. Perfectly able replacement. Thiago da Silva Violas of the Benfica club, 30 years of age now. 85 caps to his name. Started at exactly the same time as the Ferreira brothers when Portugal really came back onto the world scene to develop their men's volleyball team. Now so many of the players are on the same number of caps. Alex tips it out. Frustrations boiling over, and look at that, the timeout, a technical timeout, and that telling off from Coach Silva. It's not done his team any good. 3 points down now. Hugo Silva calls another timeout. Fresh helmets on. All teams know the score, all players know the score. Occasionally a coach has to let off steam. Coaches under just as much pressure in their jobs as the players are. And if a team is losing, their position, their job is under threat. That's how it is in world sport. 10-7, USA steal a 3-point lead. Patch tamest serve on this American team. Just slings it out over the baseline. Venikani back to serve. He too has a jump float serve rather than a jump topspin serve. And it's that tilted pass as the service receivers angle themselves towards the server. Wapatutia beaten. Gets another go at this. Patch from the back line. And that is an impressive hit. Well, I said how tough it was when the ball is coming from distance across the front of your body for a right-hander on the right side of court. This is sensational. Reuse play from Wapatutia. Goes up in the air and just plays it out high and wide to Patch. And he has absolutely thumped it. Lovely shot as he went past John Spurrier. And a lovely hit. Wapatutia with the service. That's good. That's really good from Violas. Lovely hold in the air from the Portuguese setter. And by that, he set up early, made it look like he was going to do something different with the ball. And once the blocker committed, just pinged it wide to Alex, who's hit it at 3:30. That's a long way off the floor from the Portuguese captain. Violas changing it up a bit for Portugal in that setting position. Really should have been blocked. Portugal know it as well. Marco upset himself, not for the first time this game. Three blockers, well organised, just didn't close the net. Didn't penetrate with the arms over the net. So went straight down the front of his shirt. 3-point cushion remains for the USA. Stoll, good serve. Well dug. Wapatutia goes wide again to DeFalco. That's a terrific play from the number eight. It's not pretty volleyball by any means, but it's getting the job done that counts. And DeFalco putting the Portuguese captain on his backside with a powerful joust at the net. Quite. Said it before, doesn't matter how hard you hit it, it doesn't go through the net. Alex to serve. Now, last serve he hit, USA actually sided it out well, but he belted it. Can he do it again? He can, but into the net. Volleyball players supposed to peak at around 27, 28 years of age if the body's held together. So Alex Ferreira right into that zone. Portugal will expect the most from him, but he still doesn't have a lot of experience really at this level when you compare it to some of the players his age. Free ball, Portugal can attack here. They do, but Marco into the block. And DeFalco into the block with this one down. Samosh seals up that cross court. That's the value of having a third blocker in. And a monster block created. Lovely organisation at the net. Fantastic press from Samosh to shut it down. All mine, says DeFalco. Just taking responsibility. That's what all good players should really be doing. Phelps to serve. Decent pass from DeFalco, and he gets a lovely set from Christensen. That's not bad, you know. DeFalco was on his knees when he passed that ball, but got up, recovered, and found enough in the jump for a super spike. Down he goes, up he comes. Lovely set. Free net. Well played, Michael Christensen. Well, the serving in this match, at best, has been shoddy. Both teams will admit to that. But that's largely been because the teams have had to work so hard for their side-outs. There's no rhythm walking back to the service line. Decent hit, well contained by DeFalco. Wide to Wapatutia as he got it on the line. Referee says no. Say don't look interested in a challenge. So a straight error from the number 18 for the USA. Off a decent serve from Marco. Portugal a little unlucky there. Did well to contain the initial attack, but it came back in a position where the USA could play it. Nice dig from Marco, but it's just drifted over the net, and Marco Tutia with a strong joust onto the hand of Violas and out. The USA maintain their three-point advantage as we hit the second technical timeout in set one. Arena wave. Decent crowd in already. And I have to say, the fans have been wonderful. In Russia, the support for the teams has been immense. And the atmosphere for the Russian games has been spectacular. Tip into the block. Good reuse from Samoj, but he's on his bum again. So Marco had to be used. Has he got the block? Ref says yes. No argument from the USA. That's a weak pass from Wagatutia. Restricted the hitting options, which means that the blockers can read where the ball's going. They can isolate the spiker, and a monster block tends to be the result. Lovely shutdown. And that's the part of the game that Tverikanin needs to develop. And with blocks like that, it's a bit of a mystery as to why he doesn't get more. Not going to come back. Good effort from Portugal, but Marco got a bit of a rapid deflection off his dive. Safe to say, Tverikanin's back in the match, so he hasn't scored a point from the first third of the game. Opening set all the way through to the block that he just made, followed by that hit. Two quick points for Tverikanin. Back on it. Again, catch forcing his way through the block, and the Portuguese block not quite organised and stable and balanced in the air, so able to shove it down the front of the shirt. We've just had the nod that we've got over 3,000 in the crowd already of the Russian team to play Italy, the big game of the day on the way. Decent Sunday's entertainment here in Ufa. Portugal playing their way back into this set. And that's an ace from Violas. He's made the difference. He's been brought on for Tavares. He's not the normal starting setter, but he's come on and played well. Dropping like a stone. Just 61.7 kilometers per hour. So just a reminder, it's not all about power in this game. Good swing. That was about power, though. That was a really tough hit. Way off the net. No real angles open to it. A has to find an angle for himself, and DeFalco with a very inventive hit right onto the sideline. Stoll can take the USA back out to a two-point cushion with a good serve. Tight, well contained by Violas. And Stoll very slow to the defence. Good place to attack when the serving middle blocker has come onto that court. It's the only time they play defence. So that's the zone to attack, and Alex a little lucky to get away with that. That was close to a carry. 19-all, Alex to serve. Good serve, brilliant pass. Christensen, clever reuse. D'Agostino goes wide to DeFalco. Absolutely rips one. That's phenomenal from the Portuguese captain. What a pickup. Patch goes again. No, he's missed. And USA in a game here in set two. Partly the architects of their own downfall, but Portugal coming up with some phenomenal plays. Look at that from Alex, right up in his throat. And then a horrible shove down the line from Patch. No rhythm about that hit. He's missed it. And John Spurrell forced to call a timeout.
That red wasn't very good either, so make sure we're real loose. Be looking for some of those balls, okay? All right, third one.
Polish teams of the late 60s, early 70s came up with ways of dividing the net into letters and numbers. The coaches have adopted that over the years for their own particular ways of calling attacks. We've got the pipe, we've got the 10, although Americans call it the red. On that reverse opposite to the spiker from the backcourt, Patchy said he just weren't loose on that hit, and he wasn't. Shoved it through, shoved the arm through, and just didn't get any control of the ball. And USA trail by one in the back third of this second set. Alex, oh my goodness. Oh, this is a mess for Team USA. That was a stinker of a serve. That was going so far out. And as Benjamin Patch tried to get out of the way, it hit him. Bizarre. One of the bizarrest aces you'll see. We have one on day one that hit the legs of Nelly for Italy. And that one was just as bad. And Portugal can score for a three-point cushion. D'Agostino with a great piece of work in defence. Christensen wide to DeFalco, who gets it off the block. And that's the pressure moments when your big players have to step up. Wonderful dig from D'Agostino. Really stable set from Christensen and a fantastic kill off of the shoulder of Marco as he showed it above the net. Certainly worth a chest bump. USA restrict the damage. Christensen to the baseline. So three tall blockers in the front line for the USA, and he can't put it over. Christensen will know how important it was that he put that serve in. That's not great. Side out game for Portugal right now. They don't have to win another point on this serve. If they do, it's a bonus. They just have to keep siding out. And here we go, our standard Portuguese service specialist these days, Valdir Siqueira. Missed his first one in set one. But he's put that in court beautifully. Oh, no! And I thought Marco had touched the net there, but it's OK. It was the US blocker and a terrific hit from the baseline. Valdir Siqueira has given his team a chance in this set. And it was the arm of Christensen as he wandered across the front court. Look at that, Valdir Siqueira. Exactly. Stick a point on the board, please, for Valdir. This is totally the last thing that the USA wanted here. Said at the top, Portugal are going to have to fight for a result, but if they can get a set, then that will get into the minds of the American players. And the 37-year-old Valdir Siqueira just getting himself loose for another big crank at the service line. Here we go, 23-20 Portugal. Good hit. Oh, it's brilliant volleyball. That is superb from Valde Sequeira. Lively put away from Civetanin on the overpass to take him to 7 points for the game, but it's all down to the veteran. Oh, he battered that serve. Sequeira winning his 279th cap today. Can't get it done on set point. Yeah, that's... it's not great. You don't want to show your opponent any chance. The only positive is that Portugal still have a three-point cushion, so three attacks to win the set and make it 1-1. The USA will be kicking themselves. They had a good lead in this set. They've blown it. Farco to serve his team back into this one. Goes jump, float, easy pass. And Civetanin has missed it by a long way. Not a great feed from Violas, but Civetanin was jumping so hard and fast to the net, he actually went past the ball. And quite rightly, Hugo Silva using his last timeout just to make the Americans think about things here. Full marks to the coach for the position Portugal are in. It's not the shouting that worked in the timeouts. It's the fact that he had the vision to bring Violas in on the setting position for Tavares. And the fact that he brought Valde Sequeira in to serve for Phelps on that last rotation. That has given Portugal a chance. Marco might get the ball here. 7 points to his name already, the opposite player. Might get the set from Violas to try and finish it. Two set points to Portugal. No, goes on the pipe to Marco's brother Alex, and the Portuguese captain closes the lid on set two. And Team USA will be so angry with themselves about this. A lovely lead to be working with. 3 points up heading into the business end. But it's Portugal that turn this around and win another set, their first set here in Russia, to go 1-1 with the USA. 25-22 then, to follow up from the 25-20 in favour of the Americans in set one. And safe to say, we now have a game on our hands, and it's a game that the USA do not want to lose. Usual reaction to seeing yourself on the big screen in the arenas around the world. Crowd now so much part of this game, but Portugal playing their role, certainly they are back in it. It's 1-1 USA Portugal. We got a game on our hands here in Ufa, in Russia, because Portugal are back in it. 25-22, USA turning the scoreboard over very well, but then getting almost nothing off their own serve, and giving all of those attack points back to Portugal as errors. The losing team will always say it was their problem, their fault that they lost a set, but Portugal have really engineered this well. Violas coming in, brilliant inclusion, and his distribution taking a little bit more away from the middle channel and going to the wings, yes, but it's worked. It's worked. He's the most successful of the middle players for Portugal at the moment. Giovinazzi, joint top scorer with Marco. And only just 1 point behind DeFalco and Patch, who are on 8 for Team USA. Another change for the Americans. So John Spurrier going with the same thought process as his opposite number, Hugo Silva. He's bringing Mike Amar in for Micah Christensen. So new setter on court for Team USA. And the setter that played so well after being substituted on in set two keeps his place. Violas with the serve. Patch thunders a spike early. That will settle him down. Remember, he missed that one on the opposite. There's Taylor Sander trying to get that shoulder warm. That was a problem for hitters as they move through their career. At some point, you will have some shoulder issues. You try and manage them. You try and condition your body to cope. A block for the USA. Swing, and those of you that know your volleyball will have spotted my deliberate error. It's an easy mistake to make, trust me. But Christensen is still on court as the setter for the USA, and John Spurrier's gone and done it again. Instead of using Taylor Sander, his captain, as a wing spiker to replace Muaga Tutia, he's brought in the setter, Mike Amar, who is a very good hitter in his own right. So the number 14 is on court, but not as a playmaker, he's on as a wing spiker. Done it before in week one, why not do it again? Challenge Portugal, they think this was in. USA say definitely out. Early drama and tension then for a challenge from Portugal. There you go, there's the request. Was the ball in or out? Kai will tell us shortly. Players have sussed it now. Go to the back line, have a look at the big screen, see what the decision is. Here we go then. It is wide. Portugal lose another challenge. 3 from 3 at the moment, that's not great. Christensen still on court. Still the setter. Good swing from Phelps. And at last, the man in the number 10 shirt gets to attack. Decent pass from Fidalgo and a decent shot from Phelps. Just as Alex was running that backcourt pipe on the tandem just behind the middle player. Good deception from Violas to go first tempo. That's a big hit. That is a monster shot from Patch. He has unloaded on that ball. Spikers do that when they can see space appear. And there was just the one blocker to beat. Beating him easily. DeFalco brings Mike Amar, the number 14 shirt, to the front court. It's been the case, isn't it? When you think of the likes of Kirali and Berzins, first of all, then Kirali and Stvertnik, through that wing spiker position, when this US team emerged really to prominence in the 80s, it's always been the case. 6'3", 6'4", compact outside hitters. Scott Fortune broke the mould in that respect. Nice pick-up from DeFalco, hoovering along the backcourt. Mars' first hit is into the block and down. Portugal starting to play some good volleyball here. There is a very long way to go, but genuine chance for Portugal to win this match if they can maintain their standard and if the USA keep fishing around for a lineup that works. Good pass from D'Agostino. Decent swing from David Smith. Giovanni can't make it two blocks in a row. He's done very well today. The number four from Portugal, 8 points, six attacks, two blocks to make up the eight. Good serve from David Smith and out from Marco. Smith in the number 20 shirt. A while ago now when he was a student, but played for UC Santa Barbara, so that makes him an anteater. That's what the Santa Barbara sports teams are, the anteaters. Good swing. Trouble for Portugal. Made up by Christensen. Patch. Off the block and out. A couple of good points off the back of the David Smith serve. Garnin beaten again in the block by Patch. Good hit. That's a very smooth swing from Marco. It's the man that he's keeping off court, Valdez Sequeira. He's got Mike Amar to beat in the block. He's a super blocker, Mike Amar, when he's out on the right side of court. Big jumper. Setter for the USA, but he's been asked to play a wing spiking role here on the other side of court. Beaten easily by Marco. Good work. The US pass, the service reception seems to have settled down a bit. Are certainly contributing to that. Most setters will tell you that they are better passers than their service reception unit, and he's got his chance to prove that. Nice. Giovanni Carnin makes another big hole in the US floor. He's getting frighteningly close to double figures here, the number four for Portugal. Look at this height. Tremendously. 3 metres and 10 in the air, that's what it looks like above this 2 metres and 48 men's height net. Good pass from Mar again. And exactly the same type of hit. Whipped away very sharply by Stoll. Always feels good as a middle player to hit across your body and away from the block. And he thundered that on the floor. Not happy with Violas for not giving him any protection at all. First technical timeout arrives, USA back into the lead. Silva knows just how well he has to play, and just how well his team have to play to get anything from this game. But with USA making changes in key positions, it's still possible. Here's the new wing spiker on court. Wonderful serve. Mike Amar is justifying the substitution at the moment. Down it goes from DeFalco. It's Garrett Muakatutia who's lost his place on court for the USA for the moment. Bizarre. Alex trying to get out of the way of DeFalco's spike, and it hit him and nearly got played on. Excellent jump serving from Mike Amar. And an excellent block from Mitchell Stoll next to Christensen. And handy stuff, this, from Team USA. Hugo Silva calls a timeout for Portugal. USA lead by four. Seeing Valdir Sequeira in shot. Is there a role for him to play? If he does come on court, he'll have to come on for Marco. At the moment, alongside Giovedekanin, he's Portugal's leading scorer. That would be quite a big call to bring the 37-year-old in, but he might feature in this set just to give Marco a break ahead of the fourth. Good service run. Don't worry about that last error. Mike Amar doing some damage there. Second set in a row, the USA have a three-point cushion early doors. What a kill from a setter. The multi-talented Mike Amar batters it. That is a tremendous shot. Say in control, Mitchell Stoll. Good heavy serve from him. Rhythm now about this US performance. Well, that would have been a freakish pickup from Mark. Taking the dog for a walk, as we say. Looks like you're being tugged along by a big dog on a lead. As he chases this ball down, one arm outstretched. Couldn't quite bring it back into play. Nice shot. Just saw David Smith snap the wrist on that ball, realised he needed to put this steep to beat the defender. Had the free net to do it. So just capped the shot, as we say. Need some blocks, though, to Smith and Stoll in the middle. Miss from Christensen. Shoji next to Garrett Mwagatutia, not featuring as much in this game as they did yesterday against Russia. That really was a strange performance from the USA in the second of the two sets in that 3-0 loss. And then just really faded in the third. And David Smith thinking about this one, he's hit the other way this time and hit out. Just like set two, USA handing points back to Portugal here. DeFalco from a standing start, can't get it past the block, and Portugal, monster blocks don't always have to go straight down, sometimes they just have to go in court. That was a priceless block from Simoes. Really held himself well in the air. And then they follow with that from Phelps. You can say grateful for that 2-point lead being restored. Portugal, Samoj finding his line and hitting it again on the floor, but gets himself up, puts it away. The fact is, the pass is where he doesn't fall over the number nine for Portugal that tend to go awry. Good service run from David Smith last time he was at the line. And Mitch Estall makes sure that his middle blocking partner is going to have another go at the serve after this monster block. He's jumped out of the gym on this one. Oh, what a stop. What a stop on Chivetakarnin. That is superb technique from Mitchell Estall. Decent pass from Samoa. A lot of air on it, though. And it just changes the rhythm of the attack. I just think when the ball goes high to the setter, it's quite tough to rein it all back into the rhythm you want to play. And the technical timeout arrives. USA weather the storm in the midsection of this third set to take a four-point lead. US players will be feeling that they're playing for their places come the finals in Chicago in July. What a healthy competition for spots on the squad for the big week at the end of the VNL season. Has quite Kamara done well since coming on court? Not so much about his attacking. He's had one really good kill from the pipe position. He's passed, though. Service reception has been excellent. Samoa tight to the net. Good pass, though. It's David Smith on the head, which for most players isn't too much of a concern, but David Smith wearing those hearing aids, they can be damaged. Except the one on his left ear. They cost a few dollars, those do. Well, just as I said, Mike Amara had done a terrific job on his first pass. Stumbles into that one. Doesn't make the play. Gives Portugal and Chivetakarnin a chance to get themselves back in this again. Double points for Chivetakarnin. He's had a really good, really good game. That's what the USA need now. They need Benjamin Patch to step up and say, give me the ball. I'll get it done. Service line now, not the strongest feature of his game, doesn't score a lot of points on his serve, Benjamin Patch. Nice hit. Really good, clean kill to the line from Marco Ferreira. Got that absolutely right. Chivetakarnin no long. Point lead restored for Team USA. Kamara back to the service line. Excellent jump serve. Hit a couple of crackers earlier on in the set. That's good again. Good pass from Alex. And the Polish captain gets the set out wide, was going for the fingers of the block. He's found them. Just heard those two noises, one off the spike, one off the finger of Christensen. There you go. Christensen on the net. Well, he's upset with the call from the referee, but remember, in the modern game, you have the opportunity to ask the question. If you're not happy, challenge. The USA will be asking whether this was a net touch or not. And because the point was unresolved, or resolved on that call, I think we'll have to play it again. So was it a neck touch from Christiansen or not? Somebody touched the neck. But who? The mini who done it on the challenge system. John Sproul taking plenty of opportunity to just get more words with the players. Here we go. And the neck touch is against Alex of Portugal. So actually, this should be the USA's point. No need to replay. There you go. He did look guilty, didn't he? If he played the ball. A wry smile from the Portuguese captain. 3-point cushion restored for Team USA. They hang on to the challenge because it was a correct challenge. Mitchell Stahl off pace. Nice serve. Portugal put it away. Christiansen with a lively left-handed spike. And then fills in as the middle blocker as David Smith drifts out to the opposite. So a bit of everything going on there for the States, but they come up with the point. Portugal once again left wanting at the moment in the back end. Nice set chicken wing from Violas to dig it up in defence. Hugo Silva has spotted the danger for Portugal, called the timeout. Fans ready and waiting for the big one today. The two undefeated teams here in Ufa, in southwest Russia, the hosts, and Italy go head to head in our second game of the day. But for the moment, a matter of Portugal v USA to be sorted out. It's one set apiece. Marco cross court onto Stahl. Stahl can't contain it. Shot again. Mitchell Stahl was on it, just couldn't quite dig the ball back into play. Big serve from Alex Ferreira. Christiansen races out wide to get it to DeFalco, who shoves it in the net. And just like that, off the back of the timeout from Hugo Silva. USA doing what they did in set two and just collapsing a bit here. Substitutional timeout for that buzzer. It is a timeout, USA. Not a massive amount of focus on the rotational variations and where the set should really go. I'm surprised Benjamin Patch hasn't been fed more ball. He's still the highest scorer for Team USA on 13, but these are the times in the game, these are the moments when you need your big opposite to be firing. Massive serve. And both the Ferreiras doing the job here for Portugal. Brilliant serve from the captain, Alex, to put the pressure on Mar, whose pass now is being put under some serious scrutiny. And a really good kill from Marco Ferreira to close the gap to just one. And Mar has lost his place. Muaka Tutia back on. And the substitution prompts a serve error. Smart bit of thinking from John Sparrow. Nwankwo Tutia, the original starting wing spiker, alongside TJ DeFalco, is back in business. Christensen to serve, 21-19 USA. Good ball control from Portugal. Marco trying to chop that onto the line and hoping to just pick up a piece of the block on the way. And Portugal might challenge here. Not surprised to see that there. I'm going to ask if this touched the block. Certainly looked tight to the line. And when it looks tight to the line, there's a good chance that it's clipped the blocker. Angles are all right there. It's going to be another close call. And remember, Portugal haven't won a challenge yet. Danger of using and losing this second one, which could again have massive consequences. 25 all, 26 all at the end of this set if they need a challenge and it's not there. Confirmation, one left for Portugal. If they lose this one, it'll be gone. So this is a big call in more ways than one. Here we go. Doesn't look like that has clipped anything. No touch, it's out. Point USA, and Portugal with no challenges left in set three. Clever switch up, really clever switch up. They knew that they'd been compressed right over to the other side of the court with no hitting options available. So the movement of Alex Ferreira, who's in the back line at the moment, exceptional to get himself out there to hit from a rather unconventional position. Number 10. Which is Phelps, the middle blocker, doesn't have the strongest serve, has once again gone to the bench to allow this man, Valdir Siqueira, Portugal's most experienced international player, to the service line. Can he hit another good jump serve? He goes off pace, it's cleverly played. Patch misses, and USA in trouble again. And Valdir Siqueira, who did some serious damage with a service run, 3 points he scored off three brutal serves. In set two, good enough in the end to give Portugal the set. He's wreaking havoc again. Here he goes. He's loving this. Good hit. And USA get away with it. Edge of the envelope stuff. Extreme reach on the set from Christensen. Extreme reach on the tip from David Smith. Fingernails. Saving USA. Change back, interestingly, for Team USA. Looks like Mike Amar is back on. Valdir comes off. So back on comes number 10, the middle block of Phelps, but the libero immediately replaces him, and Mike Amar is on court. So it wasn't a permanent change for Nwankwo Tutia to come on. And he can't come back on in this set, the number 18 for the USA. Substitution has been used. Marco, USA have it under control. David Smith, fine jump set. Good work from the middle player. Patch can't put it away again. But this should be it from the USA's point of view. No! Mistiming on the C quick. And Dave Smith has hit that into the net and it's rolled all the way along and out of court. And USA just cannot get this set over the line. Another great bit of blocking to slow down Patch. Jameda Cardin's doing a good job there in that respect. He can't believe it. David Smith certainly can't believe it. And this is a really interesting call. So, potentially Portugal's best server has just been benched in favour of the young man, Lorenzo. The number 12, just 22 years of age, into the net. And really my place to say, but for me, not a great call. That's a risky call with Marco now just coming straight back to the court. I'd have trusted my 31-year-old veteran number seven to put that ball in. Set point is finished by the USA, and Benjamin Patch has at last got himself a block. It's taken a while to get there, but if you're going to bring a block to the party, might as well make it a monster block. Properly roofing Samoa back in his face. Benjamin Patch terminates set three for the Americans, but they made really, really hard work of that. So USA take the first set 25-20, Portugal hit back 25-22, and by the same scoreline, USA go 2-1 ahead. But that was not as easy as they would like. USA still stumbling along a bit in this game. Portugal will still feel there's a chance to at least take this to a deciding fifth set, which, remind you, gives you 1 point if you can do that. If you lose 3-2, you take a point. The team that wins 3-2 only takes 2 points. But at the moment, USA heading for a 3-1 win. They're up in this match. So plenty of celebrations for the USA at the end of a very tense set there. Both teams making a lot of errors. Both teams not really turning the scoreboard over as they would like with attacks. And neither team serving an ace. Not great. But at the end of it all, USA win the set. They have 2-1 lead in this race to three. In terms of the US serve placement, well, not a tremendous amount of ball going out towards the wing spikers, so they're trying to pressure everything towards the left side of the court as they're looking at Portugal's right side. They're trying to do that in order to make Violas, the setter at the moment, set the ball across his body, giving them a chance of a read and react block for the middle players. I'd like to say it's working, but this is a really tricky game for the States. It's all still quite relaxed down there. They've already got their pass to the finals. Look at that gum shield for Marco Ferreira. A lot of players have to wear gum shields because you jump high, you land, and as you land, you put a lot of shock through your jaw and your teeth. So a cushioned gum shield prevents some cracks occurring in the dentures. It can also stop you from opening and closing your mouth and biting on your tongue. So numbers of ways that the gum shield is used. Four. Could also be from the dentist to keep his teeth straight, but I promise you, a few players do play with gum shields in. Two, one, USA. In the blue, playing from left to right. Not the start they were looking for. From the usually reliable Mike Kamara at the service line, who's on as a wing spiker, not a setter in this game. Second time John Sporor has pulled that particular trick. And he's on for number 18, Garrett Waigatutia. No. It's all over the shot from the USA at the moment. He's played that point like a training drill. Fantastic block. Monster block from the captain, Alex Ferreira. umpire. The look through the net at Benjamin Patch, who's not had a great game. 14 points at the moment for the US opposite player. Good cover from DeFalco. And a wide hit. Portugal wasting a chance there. Phelps with the miss. Should have been a nailed-on point for the Portuguese team. And just like the start of the first set, there's no real connection between Christensen and his middle blockers in particular, but he set a duff wide one to DeFalco as well. Sometimes happens, hitters can blow hot and cold, setters can as well. Alex has missed. Didn't look to me to be near anything, not the block and not the court. No challenge. Portugal. Well, I would be amazed if they challenged. That looked like they were going to for a second there, but no. USA's point. Stoll batters it off the top of the net. Ferreira from the right side again does enough with it. There's Max Ferreira's brother, Marco. That's the younger of the two siblings that goes back to the service line. In terms of sibling rivalry in this game, Marco's got 13 points, Alex 8. So the Portuguese captain hasn't contributed as much as he would like. It's more like it. I like Patch run on a quicker, flatter ball. That, to me, makes it so much harder for the blockers. Remember the height that Benjamin Patch is hitting from. He's up there touching 368 in a spike jump test. So he's hitting the ball about 350. That's crazy numbers. Good swing. Nice pro dispatch from Marco. This is how you earn your money in the pro leagues, putting away balls like that against one blocker. Three. Phelps with the serve. Patch, quick and wide. There we go. The problem for the blockers, when they're trying to touch a ball that's being hit from 350 and when it's going flat and fast rather than with a peak on it and coming down, it means you're reaching at the ball. As soon as you do that, you're giving up space at the net, you're giving up space past you to the court. And Patch using that well. It's better setting from Christensen. Yeah, nice offense. Pipe attack from Alex Ferreira. And if you haven't watched volleyball for a while, you'll notice that there is a very new line judging system in place, the end line judges, right in the center of the court at the back. They're looking for those touches off the block. They're looking to suggest to the referee whether they think a ball was in or out on the sidelines. But the technology is there. Hawkeye is there to back them up. So no longer four lines judges with flags, just the two. Good off-pace serve from David Smith. And another beautiful pipe attack. Alex is flying at the moment. The Portuguese captain is on his game. And this is a wonderful set from Violas. Free net, 112.9 kilometers per hour. And a quick apology from the Portuguese captain for hitting the opposition. You don't have to apologize. You are allowed to hit them. It's all fine. With the ball, that is. Good swing, clever. Nice compact hit from Mike and Mark. Stung the fingers of Violas. That's why the players have got so much tape on their fingers and their hands. If you get one of those balls on the end that just compresses down on the joint, oh dear, it hurts. Oh, wow, what a shutdown. Mike Itmar, another player that jumps out of the gym on this US team. for a monster block alongside Mitchell Stahl, who closed down the cross court. It's a sweet kill. But it's monster block. Been followed by a monster challenge. And Portugal asking if this was in or out. I think they are. Hawkeye will tell us. It was straight down. And it was straight in. I think Portugal heading for some kind of V&L record here. What's that, five lost challenges from five? Not been a great day in that respect for the Portuguese team. Good dig, D'Agostino, nice play. Oh, and a complete mix-up. Well, somebody called. I suspect it was Christensen, and DeFalco left it. And then Christensen didn't follow through. 7-all. So up it goes. Good dig from D'Agostino. And Christensen, he calls it. He does call it, and DeFalco backs off. Kanin into the net though, so no real damage done for the USA. And yet again, nothing in it as we head into the first technical timeout of set four. John Sparrow specifically talking about Marco, the number seven for Portugal. Keep playing the line seam game. They're just trying to mix that block up a little bit. They want to get him once, and that might be enough to get into the head. Portugal's opposite spiker. Go. Mid phase of set four then coming. Better serve from Mar. Transition for USA is put away nicely by the number 14. That's a sweet hit from the middle of the backcourt. Wonderful shot. Wonderful deception from Stahl and Christensen. Lovely finish from Ma, who trains with the US team as a setter, the man serving, but somehow still finds time to train as a wing spiker as well. And in terms of wing spiking, it's Alex that's doing a good job for Portugal at the moment. Takes his kill tally to 10. His points to 10, that's no, in fact it's 11, so it's 9 kills for him in attack. Really nice swing from TJ DeFalco. So you need a couple of big stall services here. Usual pre-serve routine. And the usual hit into the top of the net, but it's over. Good touch from Mark. Fantastic from USA. It's come back. Oh, brilliant from Christensen. And nobody on the Portuguese side of the net let Marco know that there was someone there. Someone's got a shout block up there. And just let them know Christensen's around. What a pickup from Mar though. One-handed, left-handed on the back line for a phenomenal dig. And that run of points pushes Hugo Silva to a timeout for Portugal. Oh,
está a fazer o passo para dentro, estás a chamar aqui, chamar as costas, fica tudo duro.
Mas
tu podes mudar, mano!
Mas é por seu
lado,
pô!
Não entrada já está a fazer o passo.
Siga! Sempre as longas distâncias, pá! Vamos tirar mais rápido! Vamos
mostrar
que chega mais!
Vamos tirar mais rápido! Vamos tirar mais rápido! Vamos tirar mais rápido!
Marvin Sequeira in a fairly animated conversation there with the middle blocker Phelps. The 8-year-old middle player winning his 81st cap, so he's more than experienced enough to know what he's doing out there on court. And his team not happy with him. Bit of work from Eric Shoji, the US libero, to keep himself ready to go in this match. And timeout, a good one from Hugo Silva. I know you've got to go for your serves, but you're rewarding a coach for stopping the match with his team under pressure. Surely that ball's got to go in and make them think. Easy to say, I guess. Not as easy to do. Falco off the block. Block touches the net. And Phelps here has twanged his shoulder a bit. Falco hits the ball unbelievably hard. If a hitter keeps doing that to you as a middle blocker, keeps twanging your arm. What is it? No, it's a... Yeah, he's completely tweaked it. But if they keep doing that, it hurts the shoulders. That's not great. Joao Fidalgo jumping forwards to the pass and overbalancing and just ricochets off his arms. And USA now playing with a lead, with a bit of control. And with Benjamin Pash in the front court on that right side. Although he switched blocks to go on Marco, that's good thinking. Slow down play, Pash still out wide. Oh, that's a great hit. Touched the net, so that probably took it away from Fidalgo's arms, but it's still a really nice flow to the attack. And USA doing what they've done well for so many years, stack blocking. So just deciding where they want to put their tallest blocker on which hitter. And it worked on that occasion. Certainly forced Violas away from the set to Marco. Fidalgo not happy. Timeout Portugal then. Portugal were in with a shout in this match, were certainly in with a shout when they won set two, but not been able to impose themselves on the game since, apart from that little run towards the back end of set three where they definitely caused the USA a few problems. One ace for Micah Christensen, still the setter on court, backup setter. He's the man playing wing spiker at the moment, Micah Maher. Good work. Long chat with Phelps, coaching Sequeira once again, and he's fed the ball. Straight down hit through the arms of David Smith. Just about there. Patch. Good swing. And the Portuguese block having to jump so high to try and get hands on Benjamin Patch that occasionally they're overbalancing. Portugal need a side out here. USA would love to go to a 6-point margin at the second technical. That's brilliant. That is absolutely brilliant. Violas to Chivetakanin. And this was a little bit behind the number four. But he's got a magnificent swing on that ball. Takes him to 12 points. Second best attacker at the moment for Portugal behind Marco on 14. Best attacker of the match at the moment, or best scorer of the match at the moment, is Patch on 17 for the USA. Wide. 16-11 to the USA as they head into the technical timeout, second one of set four. last from the USA's point of view. They have control of this match. So John Spraw saying you're allowed to move away from our service plan, and if a guy's just shanked the ball, serve him again. Shank the ball would mean come off his arms and skewed away from his own players, so therefore a mistake on the pass. 5-point lead, is it enough for the USA, or are Portugal going to be able to effect another comeback for a bit of pressure at the end of this set? Shimosh hits hard, says that he's caught a piece of what he thinks Mitchell's stall. I think this is going to come into the game more. DeFalco walking over to the net and saying to the Portuguese players, you think it's touched the block, you challenge. Now that tends to suggest that DeFalco has seen that this hasn't touched the block, and he's just managed to draw Portugal into a challenge. And remember, Portugal haven't won a challenge yet in this match. Every single one has been wrong, and that is a fine piece of kidology from DeFalco. He has just conned Portugal into calling a challenge there when there was no remote chance of a touch. I thought it wouldn't be long before we saw that. Samosh was convinced, wasn't he? So Portugal once again blow their challenges in the set. It will not help their case at the end if they're close and they need one. Good heavy serve, nice pass, Alex. Marco from the back line. Mar can't force it back into play. Another one on the board. In reality though, 17-12, all the players down there on court will tell you at 17-12 you have to win the set. And 9 times out of 10 you will. So Portugal up against it here. Oh, that'll help. Chivedikarnin shuts down Mar. He's having the game of his life, Chivedikarnin. Monster block. And the number 4 moves himself to a very impressive tally. 11 points, 9 of those attacks, and 2 blocks within that. Yeah, that was deep in the court. I think that was going out. But played by Samosh. Alex gets a reuse. And another reuse. This will go high. And tight. And a third go. No. Ridiculous. Marder hit. He gets a reuse. And gets one blocker to beat and beats him. A bizarre mega rally. Not like the normal mega rallies we see that has backcourt defence after defence. This was all about the spikers very cleverly getting the ball reused. That's the one dig we had which was out. And then it was all about play it off the block, have another go. And a little tickle off the finger of Violas gives Mar and the USA the point. He knew it. Shoji's brother, Kawika. Third setter carried with this party. Hasn't featured so far, celebrating the point. Patch serves. Ace onto the baseline. And remember, Portugal have lost their challenges. So if the ref says it's in, it is in, regardless. USA now in total control of set 4. Wild hit from Marco. USA move to 20. Well, we saw Portugal do this towards the end of yesterday's game. They just flailed away and gave points away without any discipline at all. Lorenzo is in. man in the wing spike at position, comes on to take over from Simosh, number nine. Good swing. D'Agostino on it. Patch. He does like Marco. Blazes it out of court. The reason he's so frustrated is because the ball was in front of him. He jumped out of the gym so high in the air. And then he's fluffed his lines with the last part of the skill, the contact on the ball. Giovanni to serve. 6 points to find Portugal. Mountain to climb here. Great shot. Might have heard the call of cut. Just to let Ma know that if he cut this ball hard, he could have got it inside of Alex into loads of space, but instead just hammers it off the Portuguese captain's fingers. Ma serves off pace. Good serve as well. Well contained by Portugal and well hammered by Alex Ferreira. Portugal hanging in there. In the vain hope that something will happen from the service line at some point before USA can get to 25. Great balls of fire indeed from Alex. Well, a horrible play from the USA followed by an even worse hit from Marco. Second spiking error in a row from him. He's just hit this into the antenna. Cut that down the line again. Just got to back himself on the angle. Easily a good enough hitter to keep firing away cross court. Mitchell Storm. Shot from Marco. That's better, but this time from the left side of court. Close to a conclusion now. Just see Alex's serve off, and that should be USA home in this one. And Patch drills it through the block. Can't get it through the net, but you can get it through the block sometimes if you hit it high enough and hard enough. Christensen. The floater, and that's not great from Fidalgo. Well, he's angry with his players for not backing him up, but the heart's gone out of this Portuguese performance now. Loads of match points for Team USA. They've taken their time about it, the Americans, but this should be their first win of the week. Christensen gambles and goes for the line, misses. And the next server comes round in the rotation for Portugal has to do it all himself, and they're bringing on their superstar server, Valdir Siqueira. Phelps is the man who makes way. Just great awareness from Valdir, saying to the subs, look at the baseline. If I touch it, or you don't think I've touched it, we may need to challenge, but there's no challenges left. And Portugal give it away. It was a bit of a struggle for Team USA. They don't need the wins because they've got the free pass to the finals in Chicago as hosts. But what they want is momentum. And what John Spurrier wants is for this group of athletes to keep winning games. Not been the best 3 days on the VNL for USA. But John Spurrier sees his men finish it off with a victory by 3-1. The most glorious last point we'll see. Decent pickup from Violas, but an easy little tickle into court from Patch to win the game. So USA take the first set 25-20. Portugal come back strongly in set two, 25-22. They had their chances as well in set three, but lost that one by the same scoreline. And finally, convincing from Team USA in set four, 25-17. gets the job done here in Ufa by 3-1. And the USA finish week two here in Group 6 with a win. Well, I think John Spurrell will take that. Got players to come back into the squad still. Got decisions to make for the final lineup in Chicago in front of the home fans. But for the moment, for today, it's another win. For Portugal, winless here in Russia. Still that solitary victory and a good one as well. 3-1 against the Bulgarian side that beat France today on the VNL and knocked France off the top of the table. So, at last, USA can smile here in Ufa. Now victorious in their final game of week two. Plenty of drama in the Volleyball Nations League on the final day of week two for the men. Brazil just ahead of Iran at the top of the table. France losing out from two sets to love up against Bulgaria, losing 3-2. And the next game on court here in Russia, Italy versus the host. That is going to be a big, big game in terms of the qualification process. Top five, important if you want to join the USA at their home finals in Chicago. USA do themselves a few favours, picking up the win against Portugal, just bumps them up to 9 in the table. And it's Portugal, Australia, China at the moment, all languishing in that bottom section. Portugal, Australia, though, looks like it might be the fight to avoid relegation. So more cracking action still to come here in the Ufa Arena. It's Russia versus Italy next up. But for now, thanks for your company. Thanks for watching the game.